Hi. With a high-level understanding on the concept about master key and the need for encryption within the vault, let's go ahead and initialize the vault. Already, we initialized the vault, so the path to store the data would have got created as a part of the configuration file. We provided this specific location, that is under root HashiCorp/data. So the folder for data got created, and it should be having the data encrypted and stored within this specific location as storage. I'm going to remove this particular data folder and recreate them, reinitialize it, and understand the purpose of the key sharing and how the data is going to get retained. Let me remove the data folder. Now I'm going to start the server by pointing the configuration file. I'm going to use this specific configuration file where I have provided the storage as file and this specific path. Let me start the server, vault server-config and path to the configuration file. The server is started. I'm going to use another terminal and export the environmental variable vault_addr. Now let me initialize the vault. I will use the command vault operator init. As we discussed earlier, initializing, it's the process by which vault storage backend will be prepared to receive the data. And it is going to generate in-memory master key. It will not get stored anywhere. And it is going to apply the Shami's secret sharing algorithm and provide the master key in disassembled format into n number of parts. And that will be used to unseal the vault. So here's where I do have the unseal key. I have 5 unseal keys and the threshold by default it is set as 3. I can change this particular threshold value as well as how many number of key shares should get generated. Now I have used the default value of 5 key shares and the threshold as 3. This will not get stored anyway. So it's the responsibility of the user to share it to the individuals or to the individual system. And we can use some other third-party system to store the data in the encrypted form that we will be seeing it later. Now, the vault will be in the sealed state. I cannot do any operation against it. This is to protect the data. I need to manually unseal it. Unseal is the process of providing the unseal key depending on the threshold limit and unseal it. Before that, it's going to completely protect. Physically, I cannot make any change to the data either through the command line interface or through the UI or directly accessing the files. That can be verified by using the command vault secret list. Let me list what are all secret engine available. It's going to give the error vault is in the sealed state. Let me use the operator unseal and unseal this vault. I'm going to use the command vault operator unseal. It will ask for the unseal key. I can provide the key along with the command itself or copy paste the key. I'm going to select any one of the key and it will not get displayed in the screen and it will give the value what is the seal type it was used, whether it is initialized and whether the vault is in the sealed state. Yes, still it's in the sealed state and total number of shares available is 5 and threshold is 3 and unseal progress I have provided 1 unseal key. Now I'm going to use the same command again, vault operator unseal. Let me provide another key. And now the unseal process is 2x3. Still, the vault is in the sealed state. Let me execute the command once again and provide one another key. Yes. I do have the value sealed as false. That means unsealed process is done and I should be in a position to operate against this particular vault. And before working on the vault, I need to provide the initial root token that was provided as a part of the init process. That also, I have that copied. Along with the unsealed key, I do have the initial root token as well. I need to provide that to log into the vault, so that the system knows I have logged in as a root. Generally, it's not recommended to log in as a root. I need to create a separate user and associate the policy that we will be seeing it as a part of user creation and providing the permissions using ACL. Now let me use the token and log into the vault. I'm using the command vault login and then the token provided during the initialization process. Yes, Successfully, I am authenticated. Now, I should be in a position to execute the command. Now, the vault is unsealed and I can execute the command. And in case if I am shutting down the server, automatically the vault will get sealed and I need to do this unseal process once again. Now, to protect the vault, if it's required, I can seal them back. I can use the command vault operator seal. This will seal the vault. Once it is sealed, I cannot execute or operate against this particular vault. Let me give a try using vault secrets list. It's in the sealed state and I need to unseal them. For that, I need to again provide the unseal option. This time, let me go ahead and provide the token along with the command. Providing the unseal key along with the command is not recommended because it would get recorded as a part of the history. Anyway, to try, I'm going to provide minimum 3 keys as required by the threshold. Yes, it is unsealed and I should be in a position to execute any command within this unsealed vault. Now for test purpose, I'm going to enable key value secret engine within the path my path. And I'm going to put a key value pair within the path my path slash AWS. The data is written. Let me list the secrets. So I do have a secret path, my path, and within that I do have a key and value pair. Now I'm going to shut down the server and restart them so that I can check whether the data got stored properly within the file system or not. And while shutting down the server, automatically the vault would get sealed. I can verify that. Let me go ahead and shut down the server. Control C, it's going to shut down the server. And automatically the vault will get sealed. So again, when I'm starting the server, I don't need to initialize them directly. I can go ahead and unseal. That we will be seeing it in the next lecture. Then a quick summary, we learned about the process of initializing, sealing, unsealing, and how the vault will behave when the server is getting shut down, and various ways to provide the unsealed key to unseal the vault.